Hey, what's up, studs? Ryan here, or M&R Productions, with my comparison of two amazing LEGO Star Wars sets. We have the 2004 and 2018 Ultimate Collector Series Y-Wings.
This comparison video, like my others, will use the M&R comparison system, using my special pen there. We'll go through the minifigures, playability, displayability, because these are UCS sets. Why would we talk about the playability of them? It doesn't really exist. The design, the value, and the M&R opinion to bring us a final score and hopefully decide which set is better once and for all, or help you decide which one you want to buy if you're looking at which one to buy, or just entertain you, whatever the case may be. We are in for a good one here.
We'll go over some general info on each set here. This is set 10134 from 2004, and it includes one minifig, being that R4 unit. We also get 1,473 pieces in this big, beautiful set, which costs $120 at the time of its release, which adjusted for inflation in 2020 money is about $164. This is the 2018 UCS Y-Wing model, being set number 75181. It included two minifigs with 1,967 pieces in this big, beautiful, greebled up model. There's your figure down below with your astromech droid in the Y-Wing. The set cost $200 upon its release, which is like the typical UCS price for the 2010s for these types of sets. And adjusted for inflation, that's about $205 in 2020 money. Not a huge difference.
Both sets get you started with a little astromech droid action. Neither one really has a leg up in that category. It would just come down to personal preference. However, I think that the 2018 model clearly has the leg up as far as total minifigures go, because you get this really well done Dutch Vander minifigure with this beautiful helmet design. I think they knocked it out of the park with that guy. Just amazing job there by LEGO, and he does have a double-sided face. Let's take a peek.
That's his second face and back torso print for him, so very cool looking for Dutch Vander, and obviously I think the minifigs and the newer model are obviously better.
So on to the displayability category, both sets have some beautiful all blacked out stands on their Y-Wings. So those are going to work just the same way on each set. They create an angle for the ship to sit at. On the 2018 model, obviously it's going to be a bit more refined than what you find on the 2008 model, which is just a little blockier, a little sharper edges compared to some of the nicer curves you get on the 2018 stand. The stand also has a plaque explaining what the ship is about, and both of them are a wash for me. I think the newer one does look nicer on the one large plate versus the older sticker being placed over about 8 1x8 plates. I just think that they have a nicer thing going on with the newer ones, plus they're bigger. Another thing the newer set can do that the older set cannot is you can actually place the minifigures on the stand for display, which I don't really find all that important, but I'm sure some people like to display it like that instead of actually putting the figures in the ship, especially for UCS sets where the figures don't really fit in the ship. So it does work well in cases like that. So that option is there, and it's nice to have on the 2018 model. As far as which model looks better on display, that to me is kind of a wash, although I think the white will draw a little bit more attention to the 2004 model if you just look at them, but I think they both look really good in their own right, and both command an equal presence for the most part. Although, again, I'd say slightly maybe this one would be a little bit more eye-catching at first. Other notable things about the displayability are that you can actually change the angle on the stand, so you can have it facing straight down here like that if you want to for both Y-Wings. And they both work the same way. They have a little hole in the bottom that's 2x2, and you can pick them up and do this with them. So you can have them facing down. You can also have them in the opposite orientation of where they just were, or you can flip them from this orientation and have them facing straight up into the sky. And this is my least favorite way to display a UCS set like this. I just think that looks ridiculous. But again, for the possibly 1% of you that like displaying your sets like this, this is an option. It looks kind of ridiculous to me, but again, having options is what it's about.
You can display either set standless, just kind of laying like this. However, the 2004 model does not have landing gear, so you won't find anything on the bottom to go ahead and drop down for to sit on. The 2018 one, though, is a different story. Let's drop that down real quick. One, two, and in the front is three. So just like that, you have a little bit of a cleaner display if you want to display the set without its stand. And to me, I think that small difference is enough to give the edge to the 2018 model for display ability. I think it's hard to argue with that. That's a feature that just isn't there on the 2004 model. Just the technology wasn't there at the time, so they were able to get that in. And not seeing that on the 2004 model is just a real bummer. Like I said, technology didn't exist at the time for those pieces, but still, 2018 model has it beat by a slim margin. The design of each set is fundamentally different. Each set is kind of built with different concepts because they're from very different times. I think the 2018 version learned a lot from the 2004 version and made some changes accordingly. The main one of which is one of my biggest complaints about the 2004 version, and that's with these tube pieces here. They run along, you know, the Technic axles that run down the thruster of this Y-wing, and you'll see some gaps here, and that's because these tube pieces actually do not fill out the space that they have to fill out. So it actually ended up looking rather bad, and what they did with the 2018 version is they did not add tubes on there. They just put the bare Technic axles, and I think that looks substantially better than what they had here, especially because it has those gaps. So unfortunately, it was a flaw in this design that they went and changed on the newer design. Another design change that they made is they made these a little bit more rounded. So it's not something that's super obvious, but you can see it's just kind of squared off here, and that's just kind of annoying looking, I would say, just how squared off that is versus how round it is at the front end here of this newer Y-Wing. So you can see some small changes like that that they made. Now, one thing that I think was bad on both is that they used hollow flex tube for a lot of the details, and that's fine like on the top, but especially on the sides here where you want to grab the Y-Wing, what's going to happen is over time you're going to push that and it will bend in. The newer one fixes that issue by not using hollow flex tube on the side, but you still get a little bit of it on the top because otherwise they wouldn't have had the correct size tube, I suppose. So there still is a little bit of it on this model, although it's not as egregious as it is on the older model. So as far as the color scheme goes, I think both Y-Wings look beautiful. I really do. I don't think you could go wrong with liking the grayer color scheme on the newer one or the more discombobulated gray and white color scheme on the older one. I think both are beautiful in their own right, especially if you have some nostalgia for the older one. But like I said, I don't think you can go wrong either way. Where I think the new one really shines is in the cockpit area up here. This thing is so beautifully designed. Not that this one isn't good. This one's good. It does its job. However, this one exceeds expectations, and what you'll find here is a printed windshield piece for the cockpit. That is not the case here. You actually have to carefully apply stickers, and it just doesn't look that great comparatively when you have it printed like this. So they definitely had to cut some corners on the older one, I guess, for cost or whatever the case may be. The top has a turret, but the turret's a little bit flimsy. It's not as well put together as the newer one, which I feel like is a much stronger and cleaner, sleeker design on the top of this Y-Wing. I also quite like the color of this bluish color that you actually get as kind of an accent on this newer model that's just not there on the older model. You could open both cockpits. This one has a rather large oversized seat, so you won't really be fitting a pilot in there, but there's a nice little control area and range finder or whatever that is. The newer one, however, actually opens up, has a much cleaner look to it, and is made for minifigures. So you can put Dutch Vander in there. They have some control panels and such, which is great to see. The front blasters on the older one are simple. The newer one uses a little bit more Technic and such in there. And like I said, the design for this front cockpit thing just exceeds all expectations. It's so beautifully angled off and everything. It's just a really fun build as far as that goes. You'll see a lot of neat techniques used in there to build that section of the ship. The underside of the 2004 model is basically just the underside of the plates used to construct it. There's nothing really additional under there. There's no added detail, which is fine. It's not that important to me as a collector to be able to see what's underneath the ship, but the 2018 one just goes above and beyond. They even finish off the underside of the cockpit, which, like you can see here, is just the bottom side of the plates. So they really went crazy with this one to get it as detailed as possible. You can see the landing gear up under there, obviously, which we showed off a little bit earlier. And you can just see there's so much additional detail underneath this one that you just don't get on the older version. I kind of have one more bad thing to say about the 2004's design is that this cockpit is just kind of connected by Technic on the back there. It's not even put together with the studs. So that's kind of annoying because you can pull that off. Like, it's not easy, particularly easy to do. You definitely probably won't be doing it on accident, but it does come off and it makes it a little bit flimsier on the front end there. However, this one, like I said, is just excellent and it is going nowhere no matter what you do because it is just built into the design, unlike this one, which feels like it was added onto the design, if that makes sense. So 2018 model, definitely going to get the point here, and it's going to be ahead 3-0 going into value. As far as value goes, I think both sets are on pretty equal ground as far as like how big the build is. The 2004 version included about 500 less pieces though, so you may see that as a knock against it. But talking retail prices here, the 2004 version in 2004 cost $120. That's $164 adjusted for inflation. And that 2018 model was $200, which is only $205 adjusted for inflation. So essentially for an extra $40, you got a much more refined version as well as an extra pilot minifigure. And you know, honestly, it seems like the better value is going to be in this 2004 version, because the new one, while being more refined, I don't know if it's quite worth that extra $40 for a lot of people. I think in most cases you may say, hey, I'd save the extra $40. And if this was like theoretical, both on retail shelves at the same time and their prices are different by $40, obviously, that you would say, hey, I'll save the $40, get this one, which is actually slightly longer than the newer one. This one just has a lot more greebling and other design aspects like that, but still big and beautiful in a UCS display set, much like the newer one is, just $40 cheaper. So value, just slightly going to give the edge to the 2004 version, because for $40 less, I think that's definitely going to be a better value. And that brings us to the most important category on the list, M&R opinion. You know, as much as I hate to say it, as much as I love that 2004 version, the 2018 Y-Wing is simply the better model. It's refined, it's got better figures, more detailed, it has the landing gear, the cockpit is way better constructed and actually fits the minifigure that's included in the set. It's a lot less wobbly. I'm not quite sure if like the shortness of the thruster area is accurate, because this one is a little bit longer in the back end, but I don't really find that to be important. But this new one just really knocked it out of the park. I think I described it possibly as like the perfect Y-Wing when I made my first video about it, when I first saw the pictures. So it's really good. This first one from 04 was a really good shot at it, but obviously over 15 years a lot changed, and they were able to do an incredible job with the 2018 version. That being said, if you're looking into getting either of these, I couldn't recommend one over the other, to be honest. I think you will be happy with either set, and if you want to get both, I say definitely go for it, because I don't think, unlike is the case with maybe the original X-Wing UCS set, that the Y-Wing has a substantial of a difference. I think the original UCS X-Wing looks really bad, however the original UCS Y-Wing looks really good, and so does its newer version. So drawing that comparison, I can tell you that it wouldn't be terrible to own both these models. And so here is our final score. It's going to be 4-1 in favor of the 2018 model. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments section below. You can also vote on the poll on the top right of your screen as to which Y-Wing UCS set you think is better. Again, I think they're both fantastic models. Just obviously 15 years does a number to what you can do with a newer set. Anyway, leave a like if you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe to the channel if you're new here. You can check out some other LEGO Star Wars comparison videos on the end card now.